spending 3.5 weeks in a third world country.
It's just an absolutely amazing experience.
Most challenging thing you'll probably ever do, but so rewarding.
I think for me it was probably confronting myself a little bit at St Jude's and hearing a lot of the students' stories.
This is Adrian. Adrian, what's your name?
This is Lionel.
We're trying to have a first world or a good decent school for our kids, because I believe that it doesn't matter whether you're blue, black, green, purple.
Decent classroom, decent science lab, decent library and good staff, you know, no matter where you come from in the world. So good on you.
One of my favourite memories was my home visit. It changed perspective about how we live our lives and what's most important.
The young game is pretty well, we have Australians and St Jude's kids sitting in a circle, and you have a St Jude's partner. The question we got asked was, what was the best present you've ever received?
How old are you?
16.
And you have your own car, or is?
And my St Jude's kid behind me says, to blow me out of the water, the best present I've ever received is...
Since I was born, the help which my parents give to me, I really appreciate the
more gratitude, I guess. Be a lot more thankful.
Because if we do not change today, we are the same person tomorrow as we are today. Therefore, we make the same decisions tomorrow as we make today. So, what we must learn is when we feel the roar, when we feel the fear, we must learn to be brave and run towards the roar.
So we go like this. This is what we do. This is what we do.
I was so excited to just go on the safari to see all the zebras. I was really excited. I actually started crying in the car.
See the lionesses, Claire?
My favourite part of the trip so far has have to be watching one of the lion and lioness kill on safari, which was quite hard to spot, and the fact that we're seeing nature at its finest.
It's about my 10th safari, and I can't remember having more National Geographic moments in a couple of afternoons as we have had and this morning. Absolutely fantastic safari and animal experience. And thank you.
So we're just about to climb Kilimanjaro. Here we go.
Okay.
Ellen.
We are officially now at the saddle, so
let's ride this pony.
I stopped an old man along the way, hoping to find some old forgotten words or ancient melodies. He turned to me as if to say, "Hurry, boy, it's waiting there for you.
To the top of Africa, Uhuru and me.
5,895 meters. A marvelous trip. And still with some great mates as well. It's been good.
We're pushing each other all the way up that mountain. For every person, for every step that we all took. So guys, this is for you.
My word today is do good, good will follow you.
Is this the real life? At Zanzibar. Is this just fantasy? A lovely beachside resort we've been staying at. It's a great way to unwind, basically chill out for the last couple of days of our trip.
The biggest thing, lesson that I've learned on this trip is to not take so much for granted, not to take my family for granted. It really pushes what you think of who you are and you find yourself as a person.
The people that you meet, not just the Tanzanian people, but also those that go on your trip with you, they make it just one of the most special and one of the most memorable trips ever.
Together we can go further because two heads are better than one.
It's been the challenges of the trip that have made it so rewarding and good.
Yeah, you get to know the real, I guess, the real person.
Is it just opens you up and makes you feel like you're part of a family.
I think kids have an amazing ability to be risk takers and to be that courageous. They are future leaders.
Depth of thought coming through at such a young age. The safety of the children is first and foremost in the mind of Bernie, and they have a lot of fun.
They saw that we show love to each other. We have to keep on showing love.
Sure.
Not only to the people climbing up the mountain, but to everyone.
So imagine today if we come together as family, because we are unafraid to unite and become one. Maybe we send a message to ourselves and to the rest of the world. It is okay for human beings to think as one, to accept each other, to understand each other's differences. And in understanding, bring us together into one human family today. And our children will play.